I am now 2 months into my project Tenpan, and I wanted to do a fourth update. My most interesting part of this update I will save for last, just to keep you interested. First of all, the Chanel blush, no progress there. It's very low, but an estimate would be that it has still got maybe four millimeters of product in it. So yeah, still going on with that one. My MAC paint pot in Painterly, I would say that I have maybe got a little over a third left, and I use this every day, and it's actually using it today, using my finger to apply it, it actually sort of I sort of felt that it was cracking a bit, the last bit of the product. So that's a good indication that I need to use this up quickly. But I can't really use it more quickly than I am already, using it once a day. But I think I've made an okay progress, even though it does take a long time to use these paint pots up. So about one third, I would say, there's left of this. My Gosh brow pen, I would say I've sharpened this one once since the last update, and it has been a while since the last update, so that tells you that this bastard ain't going fast. I really want to use this up, and I actually realized that this even goes off now, the spoolie. So it's getting old and the glue isn't even working anymore. But I think in my last update I said that this would have maybe 3 or 4 sharpenings in it. And I would still say it maybe has 3 sharpenings in it. But hey, who knows? It has got a little over a centimeter left before the two caps hit each other. My Gosh Let's Twist eyeliner in gray mink. Whoa, that just fell off. Still got product in it, and as I said in the previous videos, it doesn't twist up anymore. So, well, sorry, it doesn't twist down anymore. So I can't really show you, and I can't really see myself how much is left. So yeah, but I've been using this not every day, not every other day, but maybe every third day or so. Just again underneath my eyes, and sometimes on my upper lash line. It could be gone in a week, or it could be gone in 4 weeks, or even more. So I have basically no idea. Yeah, still going strong. My fifth product is this Gosh Cool eyeliner in Espresso, and still has a whole bunch of product in it. It's almost time for another sharpening of this, and that's always exciting because then I see actual progress. But I think it was a bit creamier to start with. This one, it feels like it has gotten a bit more hard in the texture. So again, good thing I'm using this up, but I wish it was going quicker. So that much left of this, and now for one of the exciting things, my Shiseido blush in Sunset Glow, or powder, because I use it for both, has got a huge dent in it. A huge pan is showing. It wasn't a part of the project to use this all up, that I would just want to see a whole lot of pan showing. And I'm still not quite there, I think. I would like to see a bigger pan. Maybe you can see that some of the lines in the pan is showing. And I would like to see all the 5 lines that I suspect there is in the bottom of the pan, all the five silvery lines. I would like to see all of them before I call this done. And still, I won't throw it out. It's just a part of my project Ten Pan just to see all those five lines showing. That means I've used enough of it for this project anyway. I'm pretty good at using this, I think, because I use all the shades. I've begun. Do you say that? Yeah, I've begun to use all the two bottom shades, swirling them together and then making a bronzer out of that for my face. Yeah, duh, for my face. While the upper two colors, I use as a kind of a setting powder or a highlighter. I also use this light brown color as a crease shade for my eye looks. And I sometimes also do that with the bottom brown part. And then for a blush, I just use kind of the three shades in the middle. So I think I've seen good progress with this overall. And almost there. The last and most exciting part of my project Ten Pan so far, I think, is this. It's the Lancôme Color Ideal Hydro Compact. And I used it up. Yay! I used it up. Yay! The foundation is a big part of my makeup collection, bigger than it should be. So using up a foundation, it's always so nice to do that. I'm so excited about this. Yeah, all used up. And I've been contemplating whether or not just I could throw the whole compact out because it's not a project, it's not a product you can get in the shops anymore, or if I should just throw this little takeout compact part out and keep the compact, keep the rest of the compact. Because it seems that I can actually find some of this foundation still on the internet online. So I would maybe be able to buy more of this foundation, but that would mostly be just not to throw this out because it's such a nice compact, and I think it's just sad to throw stuff like this out that you can actually still use and with a mirror and everything. Of course, the sponge. I could throw that out in a heartbeat, but it's just sad. I would like to see this live on, but I've already asked around shops if you can get this foundation, and they say no. And buying kind of old foundations online, I did it before. I did it before, but I don't think it's the best solution, taking into consideration that I already have a huge amount of foundations. And I would basically need to use the new ones I buy for this up very fast because they are already expiring. So I'm still contemplating that. I will find out. But this is gone! Yay! So I've already started to use other foundations, and that's so nice just to go through your foundation collection and pick the one you would most like to use that day. I haven't been used to that in a while. So I'm taking a period with that where I just can choose a foundation that I like every day, and then I might start focusing on another foundation to use up. And use specifically every day. So, yes, I hope you enjoyed my update, and I'll see you. Bye!